Hey, what's up?
How are you, Osman?
Hey, Prasanna, how are you?
Absolutely fine. Lovely catching up. Look who's playing today.
It's been a while. I got my QA completely wrong.
I took a small crash course.
Yeah.
Probably like 10 years ago for a film. Me and
Sena
shot
together. Yeah, fantastic.
I had some. The role was like, I have a pool table at home, so whenever I'm stressed out or whenever I want to be alone, I play. Okay. So I just wanted to get the hang of it. So I went to a coaching center here in Chennai. It was a TTK role, I don't remember the name of the place.
Okay.
It used to be a very happening club. A lot of boys used to come and play there.
No, but pool is still an easier game. Snooker gets a little.
I still don't know how to play snooker. But still, I now kind of know how to hold the cue at least. So
while you lay in cue, let's
leave you and the game alone. Looking deadbird as always. I'm good.
What's new lined up?
Good. There's some exciting things coming up. Probably we'll start shooting for Rona Plus from November. Kind of getting ready for the role. Need to do some weight and.
I'm seeing updates. Working out. Profile is changing.
Yeah.
And even overall, I'm just saying, you know, it's good that we've been doing this for a while now. The profile, clothing, I mean, I keep telling, man, you guys have such a large network to be an influencer for.
I don't know if I'm an influencer, but then I like to, you know, dress up well. It's always been a dream for me from my childhood to be presentable. But then even after becoming an actor, so many years together, I always had a feel that the wearing these branded stuff, wearing these designer clothes are meant for a different league of people, not for me. But then...
But that's what people actually get it wrong when they say design a lot of times, you know, when it comes up. People address me also as a designer and I correct them. I say I'm a glorified tailor. Because I've not done fashion design, I've not done a course where I can come and say, hey, I've done this. Do you credit to everybody who's done a course and like, you know? I'm more an engineer.
Okay.
So I would still say I've done my business honors in engineering. And then I kind of tapered myself off, you know, it happened by chance.
A lot of engineers end up becoming something else and more successful than that.
It is structural engineering to some extent, but
So coming back to the dressing up well part, I think probably around 11 years ago when I met my wife, then just a professional friend. She's the one who really commented on me and made me realize that I should seriously think about dressing up well.
Yeah.
And that's when I seriously started concentrating on what I wear. And then
you started 2002 Kickstarter.
Five-star
movie.
Five-star 3 years ago. 2002.
Where did you meet Sneha? Professionally, when you
2008. Yes.
2008.
Yeah. That's when we were shooting for a film, Machamundi in the US. And we were the only technical, you know, part of the film that was from Chennai, other than the director.
Oh, everybody else was high locally there.
Yeah. So obviously we had to interact a lot. That's when she said, "Can I tell you something?" I said, "Yes." She said, "You don't dress up like an actor. You're too casual. You know? Probably it looks like you don't even care what you wear, how you look." Yeah. Then I was like, I always wanted to, you know, dress up well. I always wanted to be presentable. But then I never had that. Taking a step ahead, making an effort to, you know, achieve that dream of, you know, being presentable. But then she slowly, as we, you know, become very good friends, and then started dating. She is probably a very strong reason for everything good you see in me.
Yeah.
I can differentiate myself, what I was before meeting her, what I was, what I am after.
I can see that change in terms of, in a good way. Yeah. I've seen that evolving of a personality. Like when I met Sneha first, she was doing a campaign for this brand where she was doing a mentor. So I was surprised that, you know, she carried her fantastically. So far.
Yeah,
she
amazing.
What I've seen her on screen, and suddenly you see her in that campaign, and I'm like, wow, okay. So, you know, it also takes a lot of courage. Yeah. In an industry, and you're stepping out of your comfort zone. And I see that
she's the one who introduced Abdul Osman Razak to me.
Yes, so 2012.
So you did my wedding reception.
Yes, I went to black tuxedo. I don't forget clothes. The one thing that I'm very, you know, I'm very.
I still have. It's a very
a black tuxedo. We did like she was like pink.
She was like
pink. I did a pink. Like a dotted tie. We did a very simple tuxedo look.
Yeah.
I think you guys had a photo shoot in the same
year.
There was
some
change with that.
That's when we started associating.
That's when we started. But it was still like a one-off. It took us a while when we started getting to work. You know?
Yeah, those days even I wasn't very much aware of what to wear, how to wear, how to carry. I was a little, I had my inhibitions about wearing a suit. If it would look too regular, but then I felt so comfortable wearing a suit. That's when I started really liking to be in a suit or in a jacket. But then we've come so far, we've done with some work so many times.
But that's the key, you know, what, like I said, for people in your field, in your profession, it's very easy to, you know, wear. Like even in Chennai, to wear a jacket, there used to be a point that they used to be like, you know, he's wearing a jacket.
Yeah.
But at least for me, I was in the field.
No, that's what I wanted to ask you. Comparing other metro cities, Chennai is still a conservative city. And it's been 11 years now when you started your,
2007,
your
yes.
own line of, you know. How did you decide, how did you take the plunge to start this?
It all happened by chance. To be honest, it was actually somebody who was just having a conversation, a friend of mine. And at that point, people told me OPM.
Okay.
You know, take a chance, you know, it's other people's money kind of thing.
Other people.
Concept where a friend told me, hey, I'm going to do this, why don't you, you know, take care of Chennai or whatever you want to do in Sri Lanka.
Okay.
All of the business didn't work out, but it set up my career on a different tangent.
I always wanted to ask you, were your family into, you know, some kind of business related to clothing or
textile tailoring in terms of garment export?
Because I've seen you having exceptionally good knowledge about the materials that you choose for a suit, that you recommend for your clients.
11 years.
Based on the events or occasion, you give them the suggestions what will look good for everything or
what the event. That's the key. 2007 when we started. So 11 years now, and it's been a constant learning curve. Back when we started, I really didn't know where this was heading. Or what we were looking at, doing. So I was saying 2007 is when we started. It was a very vague, phase. I was consulting, I was doing risk management. But somewhere, I wanted to be a strategist.
No.
But to be a strategist, you need to have X number of years. We need to have the grey hair, which I have now.
Yes.
But then back then, it was like, who is this guy, you know, some young guy coming and telling me how to run my business. There are 30-year-old entrepreneurs who are running businesses for a while. And then and we were going in, and automation was the key then. And basically IT, implementing IT. And they were like, there's always resistance. They were like, who's this guy?
Mm.
You know, who's this team? The other team coming and telling us how to do our business. You know, they might have not even lost money in business to know what the value is. So that kind of hit a phase where I realized you need to be more seasoned or work on good back-end projects and make strategies.
So apart from being successful
particular person being running this cabana like for 11 years now, everything. Are you still doing something like a strategist?
No, I try to, but then I guess you can't be a master of all. Yeah. And that's when, you know, a few years down, 2012 onwards, I realized that I'm very passionate about it. And it's grown.
Actually, I've seen that.
Initially, it was like I said, very vague. I didn't know. I just said, okay, let's take the plunge. Somebody wanted to start a trip to Sri Lanka. I was helping them via Chennai. So I said, okay, let's have a presence in Chennai. You know, and that's how it goes. Earlier, it was very off the rack. You come in, you see me, you buy what's on the rack, and you go. And I realized that not everybody wanted what was there. The price points were a concern. And tailoring, the company had tailoring, but it was never off Chennai, from Bombay, at least. And we decided to, you know, venture into, because markets, hey, very vague. This is men's store, one of the first only men's store in Chennai, I would say. It's moving to a slightly higher end category of clothing, not your export surplus, not your, you know, export brands that are selling their cut labels kind of thing. So it took us a while to realize what we were doing was wrong, and just changed the whole spectrum. Even my clothing was from being from an exporter's background, frankly, loose trousers, oversized shirts, you know.
But I've seen my pictures. I've always seen you dressed so well.
2007, 8, 9, I think if I see some of my pictures, I'm shocked. So, you know, that's a good change.
Even generally, even the people around.
The trend was such. Yeah. Even the trend.
It has evolved a lot.
I see a lot of social media has a very strong presence because what you see in social media is what you see around you or how you portray yourself. You know? And that was all not there. That took. That was another turning point in work. So, I've been very passionate. And I always realize, see, that we're not into luxury, but it demands attention is what I realize, you know.
But when people come to you for a special evening, like a wedding reception, or some grand evening, for instance, my film fair evening, you know, people expect you to give us something very exclusive. And you've always shown your passion to that, and I've always been the best from you. And over the years, along with that good reputation that you've earned for yourself, you've also gathered good rapport with a lot of celebrities and movies in the city. How did that happen?
Again, like I said, I see. One, I was telling you, it's a great opportunity that you guys are in the business and us working with you, because that's my way of showing out to people or to the crowd, to the market, that they say that, you know, hey, this is Prasanna, this is what he's wearing, or that's my style, per se. I've never sold what I want to sell. I've only sold what the client wants. But by selling, I just channel their thoughts to my style. Say. So I've always been, I've never gone out of their comfort zone. I've tried. So one is always knowing who your client is or the person you're working with. So I try to read people's movement, judgment. What it's always about being consciously comfortable in your clothing. If you're not, I try to be a little experimental. If I'm not, I'm constantly watching around, like, can you see that? And your mind plays a role on, you know, actually you wouldn't realize, but different negative thoughts would come in. So I've always realized, or I've always pushed things, be comfortable. You don't like the color of the day. And what I like with working with you, Prasanna, and your colleagues in the industry is you guys are ready to experiment. I mean, again, not go over the top, because I like you to maintain that, and you should maintain, and you do that. But a little bit of the journey, like you did a waistcoat double this, I like the whole glasses look that you had.
And then your pink jacket you made for me for this launch of this Open TV show.
The Sun TV show.
Yeah. Wearing a pink, men wearing pink was, you know, had its own, you know, different kind of ideas for them.
Again,
then
true.
You had to, you know, evolve over years, and now pink, men wearing pink is,
it's just there.
Yeah.
Again, salmon pink. And sometimes you say pink people, they're all pink.
Yeah. I don't want it, you know. So we again underplayed it. Nice pair of denim, nice white shirt, we kind of balanced up, and people just a little bit of that. And it's an all women show, right? It's,
yeah.
So then it's perfect when you like the whole idea of being big, you know, supporting, I think, the people who are part of the show, whatever the show is moving towards. So it's always going to be different out of box. Again, people are tired of, although we're doing loose today, it's a classic staple,
yeah.
It's an easy color, but it's a nice, again, structure. You see pinstripe, you see self design,
especially. For big events, when as celebrities, when you want, you would want to stand out from what others are wearing.
Yeah.
So everyone is going to come and walk into the red carpet with that kind of a mindset. Everybody would want to wear something that stands out. But still, to make a statement out of what you're wearing, it's not easy. And you've helped me many a times to achieve that.
Thank you so much. Thank you for the opportunity. Like I said, it's all about having that meticulous fit. That's what is very important. You see me, you also, I know sometimes you point out a few things, but I think being OCD in that, it helped me a lot. So a few things into out of place, catches them a bit.
No, what I was so impressed with that when we recently worked for this national campaign, the new brand that's going to get announced from Asian Pay. You were so much into fine details. Not only with the costumes that I wore that you designed for me, but even everything else around there, like, you know, the slightest dust that was on the table, to, you know, keeping the pen and the other properties, you know, aligned properly. You were so much into that, you know, I was able to see that passion you have for this, you know, and that eye for details and, you know, perfection. I was amazed.
Like I said, it's just something that over the years I've become very peculiar, particular about. That was my first campaign, thank you. It was my first national campaign that I was in. I've worked with people from Bombay, but going back to Bombay and doing that was a good experience. The industry is very different there.
I think we had some amazing technicians working.
Yeah, fantastic.
Yeah.
And yes.
I just can't wait to show that campaign to people.
I'm looking forward. The jacket look was good, even the others. Simple bathrobe with oil.
Yeah.
Congratulations on the film fair, The Black Lady Comes Home.
Thank you.
I know 2002 was a nomination for your movie, right?
Yeah.
The first movie you did get a nomination.
And then it took 15 long years to bring home that Black Lady.
It's never too late, but yeah, I'm sure it's
definitely an incredible film. And very happy to be in the film fair for this too.
What's coming on? Are you looking at something? Because now
I'm going to start working on a web series. I think web series are going to be the next
platform. It is, yeah.
Netflix as an actor, I just want to explore all kind of platforms that are coming up. Yeah. Theatrical movies as such, it's there. Then a lot of new avenues opening up. I want to explore all that. I've always been doing advertisements and endorsements kind of thing. So, apart from this, web series are really a wonderful avenue where you can explore a lot.
Yeah, you can do a lot.
Just the movies and actually, so I'm really looking forward to that. I can't reveal names now because I'm holding them for the announcement to look much bigger.
Yeah,
it would be nicer to give away the collaboration very soon. Other than that, I'm working on two other films.
Nice.
We're going to start shooting from end of November, beginning of
Tamil
December.
Or
Tamil? Both Tamil. Both the directors are a couple of films old. New young talents.
How long? 15 years? 15 years in the industry?
Me? Yeah.
15 years. I've seen a lot of, like I said, I've seen a lot of change in terms of the movies, the style, the national campaign.
Finally, I think the things are falling in place.
The show is that you're doing, not the overseeing show is not TV. So.
And thanks. There's a lot of compliments for the outfit I wore for Sarkar earlier on.
Thanks, yes.
Made for me. It was wonderful, that little blue
dash you added to it.
Yeah. I like, again, see you when you're willing to experiment. You knew what you wanted, that's very important.
Yeah.
A lot of times, you know, and it's for me to challenge yourself.
It was a very grand stage. You had all the big names.
Yes.
From Vijay Sir, and I want to look grand, but at the same time, I wanted to make sure the stage is all theirs. I didn't want to make it look like I'm too much dressed for the evening. But then this thing what we tried really worked. The black and blue. I don't know what's the name of it. How would you name it?
And in Indo-Western that you wore along the Ajkan, the very slight angular fits on the kurta and like an angle.
That gave me a lot of confidence.
So I will take it for
you.
Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity.
Yes, I'm looking forward to work with you. Not many.
It'll be a lot of fun. So I guess the feeling is mutual. I'm very happy. I'm return the clothes are fantastic.
And what's your plans for future? Every time I walk into your store, I feel a lot of positivity there. The way you've done up your whole ambience and everything. And I'm sure it's going to be a lot of. I think you're going to come up with a new brand.
The brand launch happened. Actually, this store has really catapulted us forward because we got hit 2015 with floods, which was a complete 15 ended up with like my lowest time. The flood was bad. I lost the whole business. Didn't know where I was going, but the confidence bounced back when I was able to recreate the brand. Bring it back, restart the whole business, and that's when I saw the opportunity. I've always wanted to launch my fashion label. I'm very passionate about a few things that are very near and dear to me, like my essentials. So I thought, why not launch the whole school as Osman Abdul Razak? Because, like I said, with passion, this should be commitment, and I am committed to giving people that. You walk out, it is the name. It's not just Osman Abdul Razak. It's the label that you're going. It's the essence. Sincerity to the work that we do. I want to change the face of men's clothing in Chennai. And I think it's perfect market. It's a very narrow market for me to have. And you can definitely see people appreciate it. When I come in, they say, hey, man, you changed that level of, and it's nice to see people appreciate it, people noticing that change. So what I've lined up now is 2019, almost finishing 18, is a line of OER essentials, from a line of shoes that I love. And I know people like what I do, so they, once I'm able to give them a lot of criticism.
You always bring this Japanese artist.
Yes, Shigeru Shuar, like a hand put in the art, first in India, definitely first in Chennai, and there was good coverage for that also. So I want to bring in experiences, so workshops, truck shows, and a new line, shoes, your t-shirt essentials, your jacket, so everything. Dude, you always, I think you are the best from here, like I said, nothing like it. I only have a few garments, but I keep, the cheeky is keep wearing it differently every time. I can't expect everybody to own hundreds of jackets, You build a wardrobe eventually. I want to help people build a wardrobe. And bring these experiences. So Tatsuya Sato-san from Japan was one first experience. We have a few more, he's back in December. We have a few more lined up, people. So people in Chennai get an experience of what's out there. I really want to, a lot of them say, man, you're too ahead.
Chennai is that kind of
exposure. But I think that's the start. And it's a great city. I love the city for me to do stuff here.
City is amazing spirit.
Some new things lining up. You will know the announcements will happen. And like when Indus came up and said, 11 years, I said, great, I'm celebrating 11 years, So nothing like
that. Oh, yeah, 11th anniversary
and yeah, like 2007. So it was great. And I said, it's good to connect. And
that gave us this wonderful opportunity to have a one on one interaction, to know a lot of new things.